Potassium is a mineral found in the foods you eat. It's also an electrolyte. Electrolytes conduct electrical impulses throughout the body. They assist in a range of essential body functions, including blood pressure, normal water balance, muscle contractions, nerve impulses, digestion, heart rhythm. Your body doesn't produce potassium naturally. So, it's important to consume the right balance of potassium-rich foods and beverages. Consuming too little potassium can lead to serious health issues. However, taking in too much can cause temporary or long-term health problems. Healthy kidneys maintain normal potassium levels in the body because they remove excess amounts through urine. Sources of potassium. The most common source of potassium is from food. Potassium-rich sources include fruits, such as apricots, bananas, kiwi, oranges, and pineapples. Vegetables, such as leafy greens, carrots, and potatoes. Lean meats, whole grains, beans and nuts. Most people get enough potassium by eating a balanced diet. For low potassium levels, a doctor may prescribe the mineral in supplement form. If you have a severe deficiency, you may need intravenous IV treatment. The symptoms of hypokalemia are different depending on how severe your deficiency is. A temporary decrease in potassium may not cause any symptoms. For example, if you sweat a lot from a hard workout, your potassium levels may normalize after eating a meal or drinking electrolytes before any damage is done. However, severe deficiencies can be life-threatening. Signs of a potassium deficiency include extreme fatigue, muscle spasms, weakness or cramping, irregular heartbeat, constipation, nausea, or vomiting. Hypokalemia is usually diagnosed with a blood test. Your doctor may also order an electrocardiogram of your heart and an arterial blood gas test to measure pH levels in your body. Treating imbalanced potassium levels. There are different treatments for imbalanced potassium levels that depend on if your levels are too high or too low. Hypokalemia, low potassium supplements are usually the first course of action for levels that are too low. Supplements are mostly effective if your kidneys are in good shape. Severe hypokalemia may require IV treatment, especially if you're experiencing an abnormal heartbeat. Potassium-sparing diuretics can rid the body of excess sodium. This will help normalize electrolyte levels. But, some diuretics and potassium supplements can be harsh on the digestive tract. Ask a doctor for wax-coated pills to help prevent digestive issues. Only people with normal kidney function can use potassium-sparing diuretics. Hyperkalemia. High, mild cases of hyperkalemia can be treated with prescription medications that increase potassium excretion. Other methods include diuretics or an enema. Severe cases may require more complex treatments. Kidney dialysis can remove potassium. This treatment is the preferred for cases of kidney failure. For people with healthy kidneys, a doctor might recommend insulin and glucose. These help to transport potassium from the blood to cells for removal. An albuterol inhaler can also lower dangerously high levels. Calcium gluconate may be used temporarily to stabilize the heart and reduce the risk of serious heart complications from hyperkalemia.